Hi everyone, I'm Dima Zane. Here are five stories you may have missed. Starting with life on fake Mars. Ever thought about living on Mars? Well, now you can, sort of. NASA is seeking applicants for three separate year-long missions where participants live together in a simulation of Mars. The first starts in fall 2022. The goal is to discover and troubleshoot problems that could occur during future human space travel missions. In each simulation, four crew members will live in a 1,700 square foot 3D printed module called Mars Dune Alpha that will actually be housed at Johnson Space Center in Houston. Crew members get to execute fake spacewalks, scientific research, and more, all while addressing any equipment failures, communication delays, and other issues that might arise. To sign up, you must, among other things, be between 30 and 55 years old, pass a NASA physical, have a master's degree in a STEM field, or be an experienced jet pilot. Shucks, I don't make the list. Nearsightedness in kids. We know all too well the pandemic forced kids to trade school, sports, and playdates for laptops, cell phones, and Zoom birthday parties. Now new research reveals yet another side effect of all that screen time: increased instances of nearsightedness in children. A study published in the British Journal of Ophthalmology compared hundreds of Hong Kong school children aged 6 to 8 to a group assessed before COVID hit. During the pandemic, time spent outside dropped by more than 2/3. Screen time increased more than 2-fold, and incidence of myopia or nearsightedness jumped from 12 to 27%. Nearsightedness can be caused by viewing close-up objects for long periods of time, stressing out the muscles that control the eye's focus. It's just one study, but it falls in line with past research that shows decreased outdoor time and increased near work impact visual development. So for all you parents and young kids out there, drop the devices and get outside. Of course, right after you finish watching this video. Larger than life puppet. This nearly 12 foot tall puppet is on a 5,000 mile trek from Turkey to the United Kingdom. Like literally, it's walking those 5,000 miles. It depicts a Syrian refugee named Little Amal and is controlled by four puppeteers, one for each arm, one for her back, and one inside, who walks on stilts while pulling strings to animate her face. I can't even rub my belly and pat my head at the same time. The Walk, as the project is called, is the creation of London's Good Chance Theatre Company. It's meant to bring attention to the plight of refugee children, especially those separated from their families. According to UNICEF, there are nearly 33 million forcibly displaced children around the world. Little Amal, who was crafted by the same puppet company behind the hit play Warhorse, will make her way through Italy, France, Switzerland, Germany, and Belgium before reuniting in Manchester in November. Siberian wildfires. Wildfires have been raging in Greece, Turkey, Canada, and the US this summer. But did you know fires burning in Siberia are bigger than all of those combined? The Yukusha region of Russia has endured more than 300 wildfires this summer, burning more than 10 million acres of land so far. As of Monday, 163 fires are still raging, and for the first time ever, smoke from those blazes has reached the North Pole. Last year, Siberian wildfires released a record 540 megatons of carbon dioxide, and scientists expect even more this summer. That's on top of the thawing permafrost and peatlands in the region that are releasing climate-warming methane into the atmosphere. All this as new Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change report warned the world will likely see average temperatures 1.5 degrees Celsius higher than pre-industrial levels in the next decade if global emissions aren't reined in. Scientists consider 1.5 degrees the maximum safe level of change. Metabolism misconception. How many times has someone around the age of 40 said, enjoy that while you can, because once you get to my age, your metabolism just isn't the same? What we thought we knew about metabolism may just be wrong. New research published in the journal Science last week challenges the idea that our metabolism slows down in middle age. Instead, this huge study of nearly 6,500 people from newborns to 95-year-olds found we have four distinct stages of metabolism during our lives. Infants have metabolisms that peak 50% above adult metabolic rates. From 1 to 20 years old, our metabolisms gradually slow down by 3% a year. And in the big reveal, the metabolism of adults 20 to 60 actually holds steady before starting to slow down again. And another surprise. Once the researchers controlled for weight and muscle mass, there were no major differences between men and women. I guess there's no more blaming our aging metabolism for those extra pounds we might have put on during the pandemic. It's the home pop popcorn for me. For the PBS NewsHour, and until next week, this is Five Stories. Have a great weekend. Wait, one more thing. Click here for another episode. Sorry, I can't have popcorn near me. It catches in my mouth. You gotta click for another episode of Five Stories. Go ahead and click. Get your popcorn and get your fix. Five Stories.